Welcome back, everyone. If you haven't tuned in before, I am Jared. I'm a digital manager here at DesignWorks Group in Wichita Falls, Texas. Just every week, I like to give you guys a tip that you can add to your digital marketing toolbox. So this week, I am going to talk about advanced social search. You can do this on both Twitter and Facebook. It's great to monitor keywords that people are using. You don't need to invest in any extra software or anything. You can do it straight from what you're already on, which is probably Twitter and Facebook. So for example, how this would work, if you were a dentist and you wanted to find people in your area that were experiencing teeth pain, you could go to Twitter or Facebook, type in the keyword teeth pain, and then narrow it down to your local area. It'll show people who are tweeting about that. And then from your business account, you can respond with tips, diagnoses, or with your business information to get them to come in and get checked out and everything and get them on their way to healing. So it's a great way for your local business to reach out to people who are experiencing symptoms and to give them answers to their problems. So I'll show you how to do this on Twitter and Facebook. I'm gonna start off with showing you guys how to do it on Twitter. So go to Twitter, and you might not have ever seen advanced search on here. In order to get to it, you can either click on one of these trending topics over here on the sidebar, or you can go up here and just search something. So for my example, teeth hurt, let's click on that. And then over here in the search filters, click show, and then click advanced search, and this will take you to where you need to be. And this is where all the robust searching can happen. So as you can see, you can search by words, and it has different categories here. So all these words is going to show up everything that you type here, and you can separate these. So if you use like the commas, teeth pain, and comma, teeth hurt, it's going to have to show up in that order. So people who tweeted teeth pain and teeth hurt, or you can just leave it at teeth pain and it'll be fine there. So that's how to use that. You can use the commas to separate phrases if you're wanting to search for multiple phrases. This one, instead of using the commas, you can just type the phrase in and do it there. These, if you do teeth hurt, it might not show you what you want because it's going to show any tweets with teeth or hurt or both. So it might just be somebody hurting about anything but their teeth that might show up there. If you want to exclude words, you can type them here. If you want to look up some hashtags, so maybe teeth probs, you can look up that hashtag. I don't know if that's an actual hashtag, but maybe it is. And maybe people use that when they're having problems with their teeth. If you're wanting to search by account, you can see tweets from certain accounts. You just type them in here. You can search tweets to certain accounts and tweets mentioning certain accounts. And the big one for local businesses is this places one. So you can enter your location and it will just show you tweets from that location. And then another big one is this date. If it's something that's time relevant, like teeth hurting, you don't want to see tweets from 2 years ago. So just narrow down your dates and it'll show people who have recently tweeted in your area about their teeth hurting. So let's see how this works. I'm going to type in teeth hurt, and I'm actually going to use Dallas, just to use a little bit bigger area so you can see how this works. And then just using this month, seeing who is tweeting about their teeth hurting in Dallas this month. Let's see what it brings up. So you can see all these tweets about people's teeth hurting, and if you were a business, you could go in and reply to these with some tips, with some diagnosis, or with your business information just to draw people to your business. So let's try another one. Say you're a bike shop and you want to see if anybody's experiencing flat tires so that you can help them. And you might want to include bike in this because cars can get flat tires as well, and you want to make sure that people are talking about bikes. So search that, and you can see people are tweeting about flat tires, and these would be great tweets to respond with either recommendations on how to fix it or with your business information telling them to come in and you'll fix it for them. So I'm going to head over to Facebook now and show you guys how to do this on Facebook. Facebook's a little bit different. You'll type in your search. So teeth paint again. And then you'll want to go over here to post. And then over here is where you're going to filter everything. So see any you want to see posts from anyone. And then you want to change your location, because if you do anywhere, you're going to get a bunch of irrelevant stuff. So let's do Wichita Falls. And then let's do 2017. So, recommendation, first thing you see is in search of a recommendation. So this is a great place for your business to be commenting. My teeth hurt, when is the pain going to go away? Throat pain, add teeth in the mix. These are all great posts for you to comment on as a business. And then again, let's do it with, bike, flat, tire. Let's go Wichita Falls. Anyone had a ride on an almost flat tire? My bike pump is broken, my tire's flat again. So these are also great ones for your bike shop to comment on with your business information. So there it is. Hopefully you guys can use that. It's a great way. They're almost free leads. You don't have to pay for anything. You don't have to pay for software or anything. You can just use the channels you're already probably on to find leads that are searching for answers to their problems. So hopefully you guys can use this. Good luck, and I will see you guys next week.